What does CRI stand for? Costa Rica? Cat rescues of Instagram? Coconut Research Institute?
Color rendering index. This video will be all about color and light. My name is Wolf Amri, Wolf.Amri on Instagram, and in the next few minutes, I will tell you why the light source you use will make a huge difference in how colorful your images will turn out. First of all, if you wonder what that is, it is a soap bubble. Let me know if you're interested in a soap bubble photography tutorial. But what does that have to do with CRI? As I said, we're talking about light and color today. To get the best colors, you need to know a few things that I will explain in this rather short video. If you buy lights or use artificial ambient lights, you may run into the issue that the colors look just boring, or even totally off, despite you setting the perfect white balance. That has to do with the quality of light, and that quality has a unit of measure, CRI. What does CRI stand for? It's short for color rendering index, so how colors are rendered by that particular light source. That may sound pretty technical, but give me a few minutes, I promise the practical use will be an eye-opener. When you search online for a lamp, you usually find the CRI listed in all lamps, except the ones with the lowest quality. If it is not listed, the CRI is usually not all that great. To better understand why a low CRI is bad, let's have a look at the so-called spectrum of the light. To do that, we're going to fragment the light. I will use a cardboard with a slit and a prism for that. That will create a color spectrum, just like you know from a rainbow. If that spectrum is continuous and contains all the colors equally distributed across the entire spectrum, the light renders the colors really well and therefore the color rendering index is high. The benchmark for CRI is actually set by the sunlight that, as we all know from rainbows, creates a beautiful continuous spectrum. Sunlight has a CRI of 100. The bad news is, not every light source creates a light as beautiful as the sun. If there are gaps in the spectrum, the light misses that color. Many of you know that effect from snorkeling or diving. Water filters more and more colors the deeper you dive. First red, then orange, then yellow, then green. Below a certain depth, anything just looks ugly bluish. You cannot color correct that by changing the white balance because you cannot add a color that simply wasn't there at all. Unless you use an underwater filter in front of your lens or an underwater flash to add these colors back into the spectrum. But back to our lights. Many of the cheap fluorescent lights you can get off of Amazon will create an ugly image. Their CRI can be as low as 50, but for higher quality fluorescent lights, it can go up to the high 80s and give a decent result. If it is that high, it is usually listed. If not, manufacturers tend to hide it. Even better than high-quality fluorescent lights are high-quality LED lights. They can go up to a CRI of 95, some even 98. But if LEDs are of low quality, like for example almost all Christmas tree LEDs, you will again get really bad colors with a low CRI. That's also why images that include Christmas trees can be really hard to color correct. See this example where the light is missing red, and no matter how I shift the image, the skin tones will look ugly, even if I take the white balance off of this white board. So again, if the color isn't within the light, you can do whatever you want and you cannot bring it back. Good LEDs, however, are rather hard to distinguish from the perfect light, which we already know is sunlight. But there are even two light sources that have a CRI of 100. One being the old tungsten lights, because just like the sun, they are thermal radiators with a full spectrum. But there's also a disadvantage. Unfortunately, most of its power goes into heat. Even most film producers have stopped using them because of the massive power consumption. This one, for example, has 1000 watts. And the last, but for photographers most important light source with a CRI of 100 is flash. Flash also has a lot of other advantages. For example, it is much brighter than continuous lights, as I discussed in my video, Best Budget Lighting. Don't be surprised if there is no CRI listed for flash. That's rather normal because they pretty much all have a CRI 100. The CRI was merely created for continuous lights. That's it for today. See you next time.